Hello everybody, I am Unleash75 and today is a video. It's a video. I've not made one in a very long time, so please forgive me for any mistakes. So this is a video to do with your tridents, and thanks to Grian from the good old Hermitcraft, he's reminded me of an old bug. One that he's planning on using the trident and pressure plates hidden behind walls. The other bug is to do with tripwires. You used to be able to hit tripwires with a bow and arrow as well through a gap in a wall, but there's a bigger improvement, and I have what I like to think is a really, really clever concept design. I am going to show you in a second what I have, and I'll show off what's going on at the moment. So here I have two walls. This one activates a light occasionally, randomly, and each section of the wall is built exactly the same as the other, each block. So this entire wall is triggered exactly the same way for each and every individual block. This one seems to be a lot more reliable. Apart from that very last one. And that one. Yes, either way, this wall is definitely more reliable than this one. What's more reliable is the ceiling. And what's even more reliable again, the floor. So how am I doing this? Well, I am using tripwire and tripwire hooks for the floor and for the ceiling. Just using redstone to link it all up. This wall, again, tripwire hooks and the wire. But this one, I'm using a whole load of observer blocks and sneak in there. And string. This one is a lot more reliable, and observers in general are better again. So what I've got here is a short little demonstration of what's going to happen. Tripwire hooks have a chance of activating twice. I do have this one set up, but it worked once and I've not had it work again, where the piston would go up twice just using a one tick pulse out of the block. I mean, I could have used redstone really. So reduce that fact. I use comparators here on a slow tick down. I honestly forget what you call these now, but it diminishes the signal every time. So if this activates twice by accident, then it still just recharges and continues powering. So this one is quite reliable. This one occasionally can go wrong, very rarely. Now with the observer straight into a piston, this one's absolutely, I was going to say, funky as hell. So watch this one. No times, that's just a miss. A miss again. So two pulses off that. Wait for the next one. It's not gonna do it now on recording. There we go, four pulses off that one. Occasionally get three, occasionally get two very strange ones like that. So that one can be quite funky like that. So to solve it a little bit, we use a repeater on Fortex. I say we, I don't know anyone else using this trick at the moment. But again, this one could have a chance of firing twice. And it's all to do with that trident. If you watch it, if I turn on the hitboxes, you can see how large the hitbox is. But occasionally, you can see it flying backwards. So it hits there. And then you saw a little flash just there as it comes back to me. That's when it fires a second time. So if I do that, no, didn't do it. Right, so to solve that one firing twice, what we have is the same again. Into observer, bit of string, a repeater on at least two ticks. If you have it on one, then the comparators here do not have enough time to switch fully on. So have that on two or four, never on one. But at least then, no matter how many times this fires in quick succession, this observer, this comparator section here, will keep this piston fired for longer. So it just stays on. So there's no problems with that. So I have a few extra bits over here, but first I want to show you a quick little game that you can play of hide the block. So you can have this one here, have a treasure map, go off X direction, north, south, west, east, X amount of blocks, fire downwards to set off the next piston to the next destination. Really good, clever way of playing a treasure hunt. But I have something really clever here, which is part of the creme de la creme, as they say. Yeah, I'm really proud of this one. Well, I did design it, but I didn't make the game. But this one, very unique. So this Grian, you from the Hermitcraft, this is what you really want for your secret base, honestly. So tripwire is getting hit by that piston when it's extended with a block above it. So this trident is actually going through three blocks, activating that bit of string. So this could be your entrance to a hidden base, huge bunker with all your gems and everything else in it, and you get in here using what I've got here. So yeah, like I said, it's going through this top block, going through the extended piston head, through the piston itself, hitting that string. So we're hitting the observer through the repeater into the comparator pulse extender, and that's been inverted by the torch here, which is powering the redstone, which is powering this block first. Two ticks later, it's powering this block, which is, oops, fell there, which is powering this piston here and also powering the piston below. So you get a secret floor. So if I travel down, secret base. Yeah, you can't moan at that. Right, so if I nip out again, so the good thing with these doors as well, you've got the tripwire hook there, which opens when you're the other side, so you can have this on the side of a mountain somewhere. This this one, you would obviously need a different way out or a slime block launcher, which opens the hole before you get launched into a brick wall. So yeah, I have this huge floor here activating that piston, which doesn't want to be activated. There we go. Oh, I'm probably out of range. So yeah, I'm really proud of that one. So I've done a few more experiments to test the limits of the Trident. See, the torch comes on now. This one is surprisingly working. I was really surprised on this one. If you notice, there's three blocks that the Trident's passing through. Three blocks again through the tripwire. And this one is the observer and bit of string. And it can also go through the three blocks here on occasion. There you go. But this one is actually two blocks away from the head. This one's one block away from the head. So I was testing the limits. Any higher and it won't go through the three blocks. It also will not go through four blocks. I've tested all of these for four blocks. So yeah, you've got pressure plate on this one, a button on this one. This one I was surprised to be able to activate from underneath. But yeah, the other way, they all work fine. But the limits on these are different. So with pressure plate, button and tripwire, you can only shoot down two blocks. And even with the observer, you can shoot down three. But strangely, it doesn't always work if you're stood above an extra block. I'm still the same distance, but it seems to struggle more often when you're not actually on top of the block. You know, you ideally need to be dead centre. That's that one. And finally, the creme de la creme again. So this is the observer one, and I like this one. 2x2. Again, observers, string, pistons, extending with the blocks. So the observers are putting into these two blocks. So it's powering the redstone here. Goes round, make sure again it's on two ticks. Round into the pulse extender. Same on the other side. Observers putting into these through the redstone into here. Then it comes up. Powers the redstone both sides. So it's powering these two blocks first, which are the extended piston with the blocks above. Then two ticks later, it's powering these two pistons here. And that's the same on this side. And it's just a mirror image. So it's powering this block into there. And that is your 2x2 secret doorway. Obviously you can shorten this down somehow. You would have to, how would you, oops, stand that there. Redstone would be easier. Actually, upper block, redstone, up there, and I need a torch again. Torch. That's all of them. So it should close, in theory, a little bit quicker. Yeah, a little bit quicker, not much. Obviously, there's other ways of shortening the pulse. But yeah, that's it for the time. Hope you've all enjoyed that. Also, I come across a little. Let's change hands. I was quite surprised with this. I chucked the trident up earlier just for giggles. And it fell down here, and returning, it flew up through the trap wire and set it off, which I thought was quite amusing. Anyway, I've been Unleashed 75, and I've got a load of hitboxes on. Yeah, Unleashed 75, and thank you for watching. Enjoy.